As I look back now, it seems like only yesterday since my son, Will, the Reverend Will Douglas, said goodbye, Arkansas, California, here we come, practically in the same breath. Those were difficult times. We didn't have money, just grit and determination to go west. And we had the good Lord with us.
Like this is it. It's not that we want to leave Sweet Clover, but Sweet Clover left us. Since they put their new highway through. But then, I'm not telling you anything you don't already know. Anyhow, we're all grateful to you for putting a bug in Cousin Claire's ear all the way out in California about our situation here. Just want to let you know, we're on our way to preach the gospel in Los Angeles. Grant us a safe journey, O Lord.
I got to leave now, Curtis. This be the first time we ever been this far apart. But Emmerine's friend, Neverloo, promised to plant geraniums next spring if I don't get back. I give her a dollar.
On board! Leaving for California in 2 minutes. All aboard! All aboard! Shake a leg, or you won't get there before Christmas.
You're right.
I'll lock up the place after you leave, Will.
Nothing to steal, nobody to steal.
Oh, I wish you could have stayed till after Christmas.
I'll miss you, Emmerine.
I'll miss you too, Neverloo.
You won't miss me half as much as I'll miss you. You'll have all those movie stars to look at. Could you get me some autographs? I'd like John Payne if you can.
I can promise, but I'll try.
He's my dog now. I want him back.
Can we take Toby with us, Papa?
I'll tell you what. Why don't we cut Toby in half? Each one of you take a piece.
No, Uncle Will. He's dead.
Well, Toby's old. He couldn't get used to city life. Besides, he'd die anyway if he couldn't chase rabbits.
Cut up his food in tiny pieces. He's got to chew with his gums.
Goodbye, Neverloo.
Goodbye, Emmerine. Here.
It's your favorite.
Hush, all of you. Leave Grandma alone with Grandpa for a while.
I sure hope California helps my arthritis and clears up Becky's sinuses. Goodbye, Curtis. You act like I'm dead. I'm only going to California. You all be good, you hear, or Santa Claus won't come.
Here, Grandma.
All right,
gonna
kiss Mama.
A good boy. Get tall up. Bye-bye. Be good now.
Bye, Jack.
Drive carefully.
Well, what's holding up the parade?
Sounds like the battery's gone dead.
Well, there's one way to fix that. Joey, Jake, Lincoln, Emmerine, slide open, take the wheel.
Don't
Don't tell me you're gonna let that child drive.
Not all the way to California, Mama. Now push, push!
Looking back on those 10 days it took us to get to California, I've forgotten how many flat tires we had, the times that pesky radiator boiled over and that dead battery every morning. But I remember so well that blessed morning when we first laid eyes on Will's new church. It was a miracle come true, except for one little problem. Emmerine was the first to ask about it.
Papa, they're gonna tear down the church?
Oh, if that ain't the silliest question ever. You think they'd bring your papa all this way if they didn't have a place for him to preach?
Grandma's right.
Why would they want to tear down such a fine-looking church?
It's even got a belfry.
Oh, son, you always wanted a church with a bell.
Now I got one.
Sure could use some raking and some weed pulling.
Mama. Oh, weed is weed,
California. Oh, Arkansas. It's open. Oh, well, what are we waiting for? Christmas?
There's no bell.
Well, anyway, we got a place for one.
Beautiful.
Just about the nicest church I ever did see. Sure is big.
A lot bigger than back home.
Look, there's my window. Oh, it's so pretty.
Oh, well.
Hey. Real organ.
Well, Sarah, it's what you've always wanted. A church with an organ for you to play.
Look, Papa, Quiro. Aren't they pretty?
That don't beat all. Son, your church has got just about everything.
Sure could use some elbow grease.
Well, you know what we got plenty of.
Elbow grease.
I don't got any.
Shall we give thanks? Father, as you can see, we finally arrived in Los Angeles. A couple of times there, I thought we wouldn't make it before Christmas, but with your help, we did. We want to thank you for an exciting trip and for this wonderful church at the end of our journey. Amen.
Amen.
And hallelujah, Cousin Will. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Cousin Clara.
Clara.
How was the trip?
Can't complain.
Thank the Lord you got in one piece. I was carrying a family.
Fine, just fine.
I hated to see us leave.
She'll be out here. And how's my little Emery?
I'm Becky.
Becky. And you're Emery. And don't come here, boy. And don't tell me this is little Bradley, not the baby.
I'm not no baby.
Oh, well, I can see you ain't. You are a red little man. Give me some sugar. Come here. Girl, I'm so excited to see you. I'm forgetting. This is Sister Beth Freeland.
Pleased to meet you. So glad you're here. And our new minister.
Her husband's one of the deacons. And Sister Cassie Thomas.
Oh, welcome, Dr. Parrish. Welcome, sister.
Thank you.
She's
thank
recently you. Widowed. What a good church-going man her Clifford was.
Oh, indeed he was.
Oh, we brought you over some supper, so you won't have to cook tonight.
Oh, my. Thank you.
We didn't know if the gas had been turned on in the parsonage or not.
Where is the parsonage?
Ain't you seen it yet? Honey, it's right through there. Well, it's as handy as an extra tail on a shirt. Honey, you can fall out of bed and 2 minutes later be in the pulpit preaching. Honey, I've got to get to work, but I'll be by with Clarence tonight.
Thank you for coming.
Well, shall we?
Well, here's another door that leads outside.
Well, home is what you make it. That's what your granddaddy always used to say, rest his soul.
Look at the space.
Wonder how many rooms there are.
Regular dining room. And a kitchen. With two doors.
It's a bathroom with the tub built in. You should see these bedrooms. I never saw such a big bedroom.
I think our old slip cupboard fit this chair.
Mm-hmm. We'll turn the pillars over. Uh-oh, a lot of air on this side.
Why they got steps inside? Where'd they go?
Haven't you ever seen an upstairs before?
No.
Well, let's go.
Oh, well, look. This is a good place for you to work.
You got a good reading life, a small print Bible, son. That needs a new ball.
Mama, come quick.
What is it, Becky?
Gotta come right away and see this.
Not right this minute, honey.
Mama, please.
Now, what's so important it can't wait?
Look, Mama, two beds.
Two beds in one room.
Remarkable.
Can Emerine and me have this room, Mama?
That'll be my bed.
This one's mine.
And I do my homework at that desk.
Me too.
Taking turns.
We'll keep it dusted and clean as a whistle.
Just a minute, you two. How many bedrooms are up here?
Two.
The boys can have the other one.
And what about Grandma? Where would she sleep?
Grandma?
I don't mind the living room couch, Mama.
Now, let's not be too hasty. It seems to me that this bed is big enough for you two, and Grandma can have the other one. Maybe your father and Joey could move it in here. Well, it'd be just like you two girls having your own room and Grandma having her own room.
Oh, Mama.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Boy, I always want a bed like this.
Not bad.
Can I have the top bed, Joey? Can I, please?
Well.
Please.
It doesn't make any difference to me.
Oh, boy, thanks, Joey. Be just like our trios back home.
Joey, can you help me?
You know, maybe you shouldn't sleep up there if you can't climb up by yourself. What if you fall out of bed?
I won't fall out of bed, Joey.
What if you have to get up in the middle of the night to use the bathroom?
I won't have to get up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom, I promise.
All right, everybody upstairs, come on down and load the car. It's going to get dark pretty soon.
Joey, help me down.
Everybody pitched in to help unload the station wagon. But that sign was always there, saying maybe we were doing all this for nothing.
Brother Douglas?
Yes.
We have deacons in the church.
I'm so pleased to meet you.
Thank you. I'm Arthur Rogers.
Brother Rogers?
And this is Brother Freeland.
Brother Freeland?
Oh, indeed. Better know you, sir.
I met your wife this afternoon.
Oh, indeed. Well, she gets around, you know.
Can we talk just for a minute?
Yes, by all means. Come in, please.
Thank you.
Seems like your family's so busy getting settled. Maybe we can go into the church.
Of course.
Come on, take a walk.
Reverend Douglas, we just came by to say how sorry we are.
That you came all this way for nothing.
I don't understand. I received the call.
Well, that was before they decided to tear down this whole block.
But that doesn't include the church.
I'm afraid it does.
You see, we don't legally own the property. There's been no payment on the mortgage in almost a year.
And the Briggs Development Corporation, they hold all the notes. They're gonna foreclose January 1st.
Oh, why didn't you tell me?
We sent you a letter.
I didn't get it.
Too bad.
I'm sorry.
Well, we can't let a fine church like this be torn down. And we still have nearly a month till the 1st of January. Maybe if I talk to the congregation.
Well, you might not want to talk if you look at page 5. Cash on hand. See what I mean? We don't have one red cent to pay your salary.
Can't sleep?
Oh, it's not that. It's... I have some thinking to do.
We have some thinking to do.
Sarah, how much cash do we have?
$83. And you'll begin your church salary soon. Did they say when?
No.
Did they say how much?
Not exactly.
Mama, Papa?
Come in, Bradley. What's the matter, son?
You got a stomach ache? You got an earache. Want Mama to put some sweet oil in it?
Where's the fireplace? I can't find a fireplace.
Well, son, lots of houses in California don't have fireplaces.
But on Christmas, if we don't have a fireplace, how does Santa Claus get in?
Don't you fret about it, son. Between now and Christmas, we'll find a way for Santa to get in. Oh, Santa's not gonna forget about you this Christmas, no matter what.
California.
Sure, I do. But I'd like it a lot better if Aunt Carrie and her family could be here.
Well, maybe
one of these days.
Papa, I've been dreaming about a fireplace, and maybe it'll come true.
It's a good idea, son. Pleasant dreams.
Never forget that first day trying to get the children off to school.
Drew a map showing you the way to school. Here. Now you take Becky and Bradley to their school here, and you walk El Marine to her school, and you go on to the high school here, you see?
Papa, why can't we all go to the same school?
Like we didn't Sweet Clover.
You shouldn't have to ask that. This is California, and Sweet Clover is in Arkansas, and they each do things different. That's why. You see any cotton fields around here? You see any mules?
Mules back in Sweet Clover, Grandma. That's where old Elmer's at.
You're all going to be late unless you leave right this minute. Now, I fixed your luncheons. Here. This is some sandwiches I made from Clara's chicken that was left over. Goodbye, children.
Goodbye,
Mama.
Goodbye, Mama. Goodbye, Mama. Goodbye, Mama.
Goodbye, Mama. Goodbye, Mama. Goodbye, Mama. Both ways before you... Be careful.
Bye.
Bye, Papa.
Bye. Don't worry, Sarah. They won't get lost.
But it's such a big city.
Sarah certainly was right when she said it was such a big city. Why, even in 1950, that Los Angeles traffic...
If you see Santa Claus, sure to tell him that I want a little set of plate dishes. Aluminum, though.
Hey! Well, well, well. Hello, fellas. Why, whose little house is this?
Well,
Santa Claus!
We just wrote you a letter.
You wrote your letter? I don't think I'll be back at the North Pole in time to get your letter.
Oh,
and I'm doing something different this year. Oh. I'm making a house-to-house survey.
Well, what is it?
I'd like to find out. Is this your little sister?
Yes, it is.
Oh, that's nice. What is your name?
Buster.
Well, well, Buster. What's your name, little girl?
My name?
Yes.
Glockenspiel. That's the list. It's awful big, isn't it?
You'll get used to it. You coming in, Marie?
No, I'll go to my own school.
Don't you want me to come along?
I can go by myself. If Emmerine can go by herself, why can't we go by ourselves?
Shut up and keep quiet. I'm going to take you up the bunk.
I'll drop you all off at the grocery store and then I'll find a payphone.
Sure would be nice if they'd connect the phone in the parsonage, make it a lot handier.
Well, first things first, remember, the important thing is to contact George Reeves.
You're right.
Old car sure did a good job bringing us here. Remember when your daddy bought her just before the war?
Now what?
She's tired. Been a long trip.
Mama, cars are not like people. They don't get tired. They just fall to pieces.
Well.
I got a feeling it's more than the battery this time.
Lord made legs before he made wheels. Which way do we go, son?
Seems to me I saw a grocery store that way when we drove in.
Hey,
Look at that hair.
It's big. I've got to say that. It's bigger than Derek's grocery store back home.
Well, there's a telephone I can use.
Outside. What won't they think of next?
I'll join you in the store as soon as I finish my call.
All right.
Oh, Briggs Construction Company. This is Reverend Douglas. I'm the new minister of the Hooper Street Baptist Church. I'd like to speak to Mr. George Briggs. Yes, ma'am, I can hold.
Hey, you. Come in. How come I never saw you around here before?
This is my first day.
Yeah? You lucky you ran into me. I could show you the ropes for only 2 bits. Hey, don't get sore. Carter's my name, and hustling's my game.
My name's George.
I'm holding. Yes, this is the Reverend Douglas. I see. When do you expect him back? No, I'm afraid I don't have a number where he can call me. I'll have to call back.
You didn't talk to him.
After all this time and 30 cents. Well, at least you got the groceries.
$6.10 worth.
9 cents a pound for tomatoes. Can you believe it?
That night, we sat down to our first home-cooked meal in California.
Mm. Fine supper, Sarah.
Thank you.
Mama? Don't you think so, children?
Yeah,
it was a great dinner, Ma.
You sure are a good cook.
Well, we thank you.
Well, I hope your first day at school was as fulfilling as our first California home-cooked meal. How did things go?
Oh, right off the bat, I met this guy named Connie. I saw him again in gym.
Boy, you should have seen him in gym.
They had a swimming pool. An honest-to-God swimming pool.
Don't seem right. Swimming in December?
Well, this is California, Mama.
Well, let's clear this table away so you all can do your homework. Did you notice Emmerine at supper? She seemed so quiet.
Well, she couldn't have had a word in edgewise even if she wanted to. You want to wash your wipe?
Take your pick.
Wipe.
Mama, I'm going to take a bath.
All right. Don't stay in there too long. Give everyone a chance.
Okay.
Doing your homework?
No, Mama.
another letter to Neverloo. Well, I guess you've got a lot to tell her about your first day in a new school, your new friends. Emmerine, you didn't have much to say about school. Did everything go all right?
Yes, Mom.
Well, give Neverloo my best. And don't you stay up too late. Covers with you. Come on, under. All right, come give Mama a kiss.
Good night, Joey.
Night.
Joey?
Yeah?
Could you build a fireplace for Santa Claus to come in?
Baby.
And a dog house?
You got no dog. Go to sleep.
Baby Toby will miss me so much he'll run away and find me.
Bradley.
I'm asleep. See, Mama, I hurry.
That's my good girl. Good night.
Night.
Oh, going to bed, Mama?
If I can make it up these stairs. Good night.
Good night. I haven't seen you all afternoon.
There's a lot to do in the church.
Let the children help you on Saturday. You know how handy Joey is.
Mm-hmm. Handy as a pocket on a shirt. Sarah.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what I'd do without you.
Likewise, Will Douglas. You better job.
No, I mean an extra job. Temporarily. Until after Christmas, anyway.
We'll manage.
That first Saturday morning was a beautiful, sunny California morning.
All right. Hit the deck. Gather up the elbow grease. Break out the brooms. Let's get the church ship shape. 5 minutes to child time. 5 minutes.
Joey! Joey! Wake up, Joey, and help me down.
Oatmeal. Mm. It's good. We need something to stick to the ribs this morning. It's going to be a busy Saturday.
Break.
next morning, Will looked so proud, standing in the pulpit, preaching his first sermon in Los Angeles.
This has been, oh Lord.
Yes. A great day.
My first sermon in California.
Thank you, Lord.
And I hope not my last.
It won't be.
No.
It won't be. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You say it won't be, Sister Beth.
No, it won't.
But I see signs outside to say they're tearing this church down.
No.
No, no.
Now, are we going to let them do that?
No.
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 No, we're with you.
Then help me. Help me.
Yes.
Brothers. Sisters, help me.
Yes.
Bring a friend.
Yes.
Have your friend bring a friend.
No, we will.
Let the Lord see this church jam-packed by Christians.
It'll be jam-packed, Cousin Will.
That's right. Jam-packed by Christmas.
Yes, indeed,
Lord.
Impossible?
No.
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 Make this Christmas dream of mine come true. We can do it. Believe me. We can do it.
I believe you, son.
Oh,
I believe you.
Monday morning, bright and early, Will went downtown to see Mr. Briggs. He was pretty sure once he talked to him, it would end all this talk about tearing down the church.
Reverend Douglas is still waiting, and I have Mr. McGarry on line, too.
I'll see Reverend Douglas now. Tell Mr. McGarry I'll get back to him.
Yes, sir. You may go in now, Reverend Douglas.
Thank you.
Mr. McGarry, can he call you back? Thank you.
You, Mr. Briggs? You're the new pastor at Hooper Street Baptist Church. Won't you sit down?
Thank you.
This is a very imposing office, Mr. Briggs.
And you're surprised.
I must admit I am.
I'm getting used to it, Reverend Douglas. People expect to see a white man sitting where I'm sitting, isn't that right? Mm-hmm. Well, times are changing. This is 1950, not 1850. Reverend Douglas, can I be frank with you?
I wouldn't have it any other way.
That look in your eyes when you first saw me, I resent that look, especially when it comes from our people. It says to me that I'm not supposed to be president of a big company. You know what I say to that? Bull. I could even be more explicit, but you're a minister and I respect your sensitivity.
I appreciate your concern.
See this? This is a shopping center I'm going to build. Now, to build it, I've got to tear down the church, which is why you're here. Isn't that right?
That's right.
Now, before you say anything, let me tell you how I feel. I want to help our people, too, just as you do. But in a more practical way.
Why can't we be practical without tearing down the spiritual? Why does the church have to go? It's been a part of this community since...
1911. Hey, don't look so surprised there, Reverend. My father's name's on the cornerstone of that church. You'll find his name in the church records. I have to admit, I'm going to feel something here when they bulldoze that church. But up here, I know I'm doing the right thing.
You think it's right to tear down a church?
That church, yes. Reverend, how many were in the congregation Sunday? And how much did you take up in the collection?
Not enough.
My daddy used to pass the collection every Sunday when I was growing up. His generation believed what you preached. Humility. Be meek and long-suffering. Get your reward in heaven. But I don't buy it. I buy living right here, heaven on earth, right now, civil rights for everyone.
Excuse me. Yes, Miss Yeager?
It's Albert Cochran calling from Chicago. He says it's urgent.
I'll be right with him. I'm sorry. It's been very nice meeting you.
My pleasure. When can we talk again?
I think I've said all I have to say about that.
Oh, you have, Mr. Briggs, but I haven't said my piece yet. You tell me when.
Excuse me. Al, one second. I'm awfully sorry. I'm very busy. It's good to hear your voice. How's Chicago? Cold? Hey, Al, about those contracts.
Oh, Lord. I'll never forget it as long as I live. Your Curtis yelling at that new like that new could understand everything Curtis was saying.
We sold him the next day.
Who, Curtis? Oh, ain't Bessie. Lord, them were good times.
We had some good times in Sweet Clover, didn't you?
Best times ever when you're young. Ooh. It feels good to take a day off.
It looks to me like you're working as hard as ever.
Well, it ain't the same when you're talking over old times, ain't Bessie?
Where is it you work exactly, Clara?
In Beverly Hills, honey, where all the big movie stars live.
Oh, you work for a movie star?
No, right now I'm doing housework for a car dealer. But I did see Eddie Cantor one day, just as I got off the bus, walk right past me, close enough for him to just reach out and touch him.
Oh, Emma Reed would enjoy hearing about that.
Is there a lot of work?
Oh, not for the men folks. It's been awful. Now, my Clarence, he's been looking since before Labor Day and can't find a job. But for us women folk, the people I work for always asking, do I know somebody that can do housework for their friends? Can't get enough cleaning women. Hey, Beth, I just remember that time back in Sweet Clover.
Hey, what's the rush?
I got things to do.
What you got to do? Hey, what are you going in there for?
Thank you.
How'd you do?
He took my name. He told me to come back tomorrow.
I did better than you did. Gotta take it back. Make me. What you gonna do, squeal on me? Joey! Joey!
You, what are you doing there?
I was just putting it back.
Sure. Sure you were. Get out. Get out before I call the police. Don't ever let me catch you in here again.
Joe, you're okay. You're okay.
Now, why don't you just leave me alone, all right? Just leave me alone.
See you in school tomorrow, Joey.
See Mr. Riggs today?
Saw him.
What did he say?
Same thing the signs outside say.
Oh, well. What are you going to do now?
First thing tomorrow, I'm going out looking for a job.
But you can't do that. The church comes first. You've got to do something about the church.
Sarah, I didn't tell you. But the church can't afford to pay me my salary. Now, we've got to live.
I'll get a job.
No.
Will, I'll work just until you get the church on its feet again.
Mama, Papa, guess what? I got a job washing cars. Won't that be great? Now I can help out. Mama, Papa was wrong.
That's wonderful, Joey. Just wonderful. We're so proud of you. Aren't we, Will?
The day we women started to work was a sad day for Will. But we didn't know it at the time.
Promised the wives and mothers of the 24th Division their sons will be home for Christmas in spite of heavy counterattacks at the Yalu River. There was no comment from President Truman. The time, 6:30.
Will. What are you doing up?
Seeing my woman off to work.
Then you're not upset anymore?
Well, I'd be lying if I said it wasn't.
Will?
Uh-huh.
Are you going to see Mr. Briggs again today?
Sarah, you're a pillar of strength.
I've got to hurry. I'll miss my bus. Emery knows about fixing supper.
One thing I can do today is get that car fixed. At least you won't have to ride the bus.
Good morning, Sarah.
Well, nice morning, isn't it?
Mama, where are you going?
Well, I talked to your cousin Clara last night, too. She's got everything arranged.
You can't go to work at your age.
What's wrong with my age? You think I should be put out to pasture? Is that what you think of me, Bill Douglas?
Good. We better hurry if we're going to catch the 7:10 bus Clara said she'd wait for.
Lord, I hope they
make. There they come.
Hurry, Mama.
Oh.
We're coming.
I'm coming.
Oh. It's all right now. It's all right.
It was a longer walk than I thought.
As long as you got here.
Tomorrow morning, we'll start earlier. How much is it?
You use tokens. 3 for a quarter.
I got 3.
No, we pay our own way. Ain't Bessie just for the day.
We transfer, please.
Transfers? We change to another red car and a bus. Just to get to Beverly Hills.
Ain't Bessie, you got a lot to learn about Los Angeles. Come on, we'll go down a little further.
Come on, Mama.
And Bessie, sit right here.
Nice morning.
Too damp and cold. Arthritis.
Oh, me too.
Last week was much nicer.
Well, I don't know. I wasn't in California last week. I just come from Arkansas.
Arkansas?
Uh-huh.
What part?
Southwest. Sweet Clover.
Sweet Clover? Lordy. Ain't that something? I come from Calhoun County.
No.
Yes.
When?
Oh, around about... this time last year, right near Christmas.
Sarah, she's from Calhoun County. This my daughter-in-law, Sarah Douglas.
How do you do?
Hello.
Fanny, I didn't know you live in Calhoun County.
Clara, all my life.
I'm Bessie Douglas.
Oh, I'm Fanny Mitchell. Now tell me, what brought you way out here to California?
Curtis is 1941 Ford. No, I come here with my son and his family. My son's a new pastor over at the Baptist Church on Hooper Street.
Lordy, I used to go to that church. I didn't like the preacher, though. Too long face for me.
Well, you just transfer right back, Fanny. You'll like my Will. Ain't nothing long-faced about Will.
Track block. Transmission's leaking. That's shot. All your wires are loose down there.
Can it be fixed?
Anything can be fixed. Just take money.
How much?
Too much. I'd jump it if I were you.
Oh, I can't do that. It belonged to my father.
Yeah, you do get attached to cars. I can remember my old 1932 Chevy with the rumble seat. Oh, say, I got a brother-in-law across town who runs a junkyard. He told us to wait for you. Even give you a few bucks. Here's his card if you want to call him.
Thank you.
Take it.
Mr. Briggs is taking a long lunch today. That's not like him.
Well, he's a busy man.
Very. Briggs Development Corporation. Mr. Briggs, I was wondering what... Yes, could you speak a little louder? I can't hear you. Tom Hendy called from Cleveland. I have a whole list of people here who... Well, yes, I'll explain to all of them. Oh, Mr. Briggs, Reverend Douglas. He hung up before I could tell him you were here. He was at the airport. He's flying to Chicago this afternoon.
How long will he be gone?
Maybe a week.
A week?
Maybe longer.
Time.
Guy owns Aquilon? Free registration like I told you?
Yes, and I've signed it.
$15, like we agreed on the phone.
Thank you. But how could you know how much it was worth without seeing it?
All clunkers are the same, $15. Chevys or Cadillacs, they all clunk out alike, just like people.
Till 3 in the p.m.
Just lay there with these black patches over her eyes.
Oh, some people. Some people is right.
Mama, did she ever get up?
Did she ever? She got up like she'd been stung by a hornet when her man come through that door. I've never seen anybody get dressed so bad. And when he sees her, he says... Did you have a tough day today, sweetheart? And she says, oh. Like that.
Oh. Boys, where we get off?
Oh. We got here so fast. My goodness.
Will must have got the car fixed.
Sure looks that way.
Hey, Mom.
Look what I got. Mr. Fisk gave me a whole dollar washing cars. I can remember when I worked a whole week for a dollar washing clothes.
Times are changing, Mama. Wonderful, son.
Hello.
Oh. Look, Mama, I set the table.
So did I.
You're Mama's little helpers.
Something smells good.
Emmerine? Emmerine.
Hi, Mama.
It makes me hungry.
Just like you make it, Mama. Taste it.
Of Job. So you'll forgive me, Lord, if I seem a little angry with the world. Maybe it's not the world I'm angry with, but myself. Well, you have enough problems without mine. Just give me the strength to face my family with a smile I don't feel. Heart rejoiced in all thy labor. This is thy portion of all thy labor. Ecclesiastes chapter 2, verse 10, loosely transcribed. Ice cream and cake.
Oh,
be just like a church ice cream social back home.
It's on Papa, Mama. I thought he'd want us to have a treat. Mama, I sold Papa's car today. Didn't want to, but cost too much to have it repaired.
Well, you did what you had to do, son.
Joey, supper.
You can't believe this house where I'm working. Four bathrooms. Can you imagine?
Why would two people need four bathrooms? Oh, I've seen big houses in the movies before.
I always thought that was make-believe. Well, it's not make-believe, I can tell you. It's real. With a swimming pool.
You're not going back there anymore.
What?
You're through working. So is Mama. Unto the woman, he said, thy desire shall be unto thy husband, and he shall rule over thee. I'm going to be the man of this house.
Oh, Will.
Oh, I guess I should have listened to old Deacon Williams 16 years ago. He was the one I went to when I first felt my calling was to preach the gospel. And I told him, he said, Will, the Kansas City Monarchs can use you a lot more than the Lord. With your 380 batting average, you're supposed to be an outfielder, not a preacher.
But you fooled him.
Did I say? Or did I only fool myself? Yeah. Too late for a baseball career, but maybe some other field. I'm giving up the ministry.
Will.
Don't try to argue me out of it, Sarah. I can't hold it with you. Not tonight.
Whatever you say, Will. You do whatever you feel.
Any kind of job.
Well, Reverend Douglas.
Forget. Reverend, I'm giving up the ministry. No, it's just.
I don't have anything here for a college man like yourself.
But I'm not asking for a white collar job. I need work.
So do a lot of men like you, Mr. Douglas. I just don't know what to tell you.
Wasn't too much work for folks back in 1950, especially black men. We heard rumors the government might be making new laws any day now, something about equal opportunity for everyone. But at that time, it was just rumors. In all the confusion of Will looking for work and trying to save the church, we overlooked Emmerine's problem. Until that night, Sarah was reading a letter from home.
Then Carrie goes on to say, and this is for you, Brad. Little Curtis and Toby are getting along fine now. Except, at first, I think the dog missed Bradley.
I miss Toby, too.
Can't believe Christmas is only 2 weeks away. Mama, just think. This is the first Christmas we've ever been apart. Maybe next year, the good Lord willing, we all can be together again. Have a Merry Christmas, your loving daughter, Carrie.
I wish we were back in Sweet Clover right now. I wish we had never came out here. I hate California. I hate it.
What's wrong with Emery?
Why is she crying?
Emery. Oh, baby. Oh, I know, baby, I know. I know you're homesick with missing Sweet Clover and Nebaloo. Why, you get over it, honey. Why, in a few weeks, you have made so many.
Oh, I won't. I hate school. I hate everyone in school. Why can't I go back to Sweet Clover? Please, don't make me go back to that school. I'll die if I go back. Please.
Emmerine.
Will, she'll be all right. You go on downstairs.
No, Sarah. Emmerine said hate. It's a word we don't use in this house. Why this hate?
You would understand, Papa.
Well, not unless you tell me.
It's the girls at school.
What about them?
They make fun of me. They make fun of my hair because it comes from Sweet Clover. And nobody likes me. And I hate them. I hate all of them. No matter what you say, Papa, I can't help it. I hate them.
All right, Emmerine. Go right ahead and hate.
Will!
Now, Sarah, let me handle this. Emmerine, you get all the hate out of your system so that the love that's in you can come out.
It won't do anything. It won't. They still won't like me.
Does that sound like my little girl? If I didn't know any better, I'd think you were giving up without a try.
I can't help it.
Yes, you can. Don't toss in the sponge without a fight.
You're going to see Mr. Briggs again.
Tomorrow, first thing.
You could ride on the bus with us when we go to work.
Look, about your job.
Will, before you say anything, Mama and I want to help. Please, let us.
Well.
Now, what are you going to say to Mr. Briggs in the morning?
This is the entire block. This vacant place here, that's where the church stands. Today. Now, if the shopping center is all around here,
what's wrong with leaving the church right where it is?
It's a parking area. One of the things we're learning here is that you've got to have plenty of room for cars.
Why not this area here?
Reverend Douglas, I respect your feelings. And it's admirable to be an idealist, but you've got to face facts. Now, your church is in debt up to its belfry, which incidentally doesn't even have a bell.
Yes, I know. We'll pay if you'll just give us a little more time.
Time? I extended the loan for a year. And how much money have I received? Nothing, not one penny.
But when we get a bigger congregation...
How? With bingo?
Excuse me, sir. You a Baptist by chance?
I'm a Baptist, but not by chance. I was born a Baptist.
Aha. Uh-huh. I'm Reverend Douglas, the new pastor of the Street Baptist Church.
Charlie Pritchard. How did you go to that church?
Well, sure wish you'd come back. Maybe next Sunday. Meet my family. Family's bigger than the congregation.
Large family, Reverend?
Small congregation, Mr. Pritchard.
Yes?
Why, I expected to see you in a wheelchair.
Oh?
I'm Reverend Douglas, your new pastor. Didn't see you in church.
Oh, Reverend Douglas, you're something else. Come on in and have a cup of coffee.
Thank you, Will.
My son Will was never one to toss in the sponge, I can tell you. He really got around gathering in the people for his church. He figured it was the one way he had to convince Mr. Briggs. One bright spot. Joey was working in the car wash, not making much money, but hoping to earn enough to buy Christmas presents for his family.
How'd you like your job, Joey? You still mad at me? What's so bad? Come on.
Well, okay.
How about a movie? It's a good war picture at the Majestic. 12 o'clock high.
Nah, I gotta get home. You gonna walk me home?
Haven't got anything else to do. What you going in there for?
This is where I live.
You're kidding.
You want to come in?
What have I got to lose?
Papa, this is Carter. This is my father, Reverend Douglas.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet any friend of Joey's.
You're a preacher?
Joey tell you?
I didn't know you was a preacher's son, Joey.
Does it make any difference?
No. Well, why should it make a difference?
Oh, I thought I heard voices.
This is Carter, Mom.
Pleased to meet you, Carter.
Likewise.
Will you be staying for supper?
Well, you're more than welcome to, of course, unless your family's expecting you.
No, they won't expect me. They won't even notice I'm not there.
Then it's settled. I'll put an extra plate on.
Mommy, you didn't have to invite Carter to stay for supper.
Joey, we always have enough food to feed a friend.
That's just it, Mama. I don't know if Carter is a friend.
You, attend church, Carter?
Off and on, I guess.
Your family?
Same thing, I guess.
How about your friends?
I guess you'd have to ask him yourself.
Maybe I will.
Maybe you won't want to meet the guys.
Aren't you saying maybe the guys won't want to meet me? Carter, just for tonight, suppose I'm Joey's father rather than Reverend Douglas.
Yeah. Yeah, that's great.
Hey, mister. How about a spit shine? Best in L.A.
Knock it off, Rufus. This is Joey's old man. Stay out of here.
Hi, gang. That's what Carter said to say.
Have a shine on the house. Hey, shine. Give Joey's old man a shine.
I'll pay.
Nah. All right, let's pop that rag.
What racket you in?
Racket?
Yeah, everybody's got a racket.
Oh, I'm, a con man.
What's the deal?
I'm trying to get a few people interested in something I got going. Now, maybe you fellas can help.
What's in it for us? Yeah, we ain't gonna do nothing for nothing.
Yeah.
Well, now, I got to know you guys a whole lot better before I let you in on this.
Why? We look stupid or something?
Oh, I'm supposed to answer a question like that 12 to 1?
No.
You're okay. He's okay for somebody's old man, huh, gang?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, Joe, your old man's okay.
Any basketball players here?
Yeah.
Why don't we get a basketball team started? I play a little basketball myself.
Yeah? What do we play?
Why don't you fellas come over to our house, say, Saturday morning? Play on our basketball court. Hey, that's a good job.
You got a basketball court?
How much for the shine?
No charge.
Well, thank you.
Where do you live?
Oh, Carter knows. Carter wanted to bring the fellas over Saturday morning.
Sure.
All right, see you Saturday.
Yeah.
Hey, he's an all right guy.
Yeah, where did he come from? Arkansas. He's the new preacher at the Baptist Church on Hooper Street.
You're kidding. A preacher.
Don't hold that against me.
Papa, how could you say we have a basketball court when we don't?
I didn't say we had one, Joey. I said, why don't you come over and play on our court, which we will have by Saturday. with your help, and possibly a little assistance from the Almighty, if he sees fit. Find what you're looking for?
Oh. No, I'm just looking at our old car. Got a couple of poles for a basketball court?
Over here. Your daddy a basketball coach?
No, he's the new pastor at the Hoop Street Baptist Church.
The new preacher man? How come he didn't tell me that?
This one looks okay.
Here's another good one.
How much are they?
Well, for the preacher, no charge.
For free?
Well, Christmas is coming on, and I should have given the Reverend more for his car. Hey, I'll deliver him.
Thanks. I don't know how to thank
you. Oh, that's okay.
How much is that?
Oh, yeah, that. Tell you what, I'll deliver it with the poles.
No, can't deliver it till Christmas Eve. I can't accept it unless you let me pay for it. It's a present. My pop says you don't give presents unless it's something you made yourself or paid for yourself.
Hmm, that's a nice thing to teach kids.
Well, how much is it worth?
$25.
Oh.
New. Secondhand, $250.
I'll take it.
Boy, you drive a hard bargain.
Can I give you 50 cents and the rest as I earn it?
Got yourself a deal.
How'd you get a basketball?
The same way you got the poles, Joey.
his mama. Well, Mama's a very strong lady.
I've always told myself that. Mama's not like other people. She's too strong to get sick. It's my excuse for letting her do things I know she shouldn't do. Why did I let her go to work again?
You mustn't blame yourself. That's not gonna help Mama.
But I feel so helpless. I can't do anything for her now except pray, and I don't even do a good job of that.
Joey, do you think Grandma's gonna die?
No.
You sure?
Nobody can be sure.
She could die, couldn't she? Like Grandpa.
Could be angina. That's a heart condition. And then again, it may be just a complete exhaustion.
Change of climate, age.
Could we see it? Yes.
Silliest thing in the world, me in bed like this. All this fuss about me being a little overcome by the heat.
Mama. You don't get overcome by heat with temperatures in the low 70s.
In December, you do. If you're not used to it being this hot.
Mrs. Douglas, I want to put you into the hospital.
Oh, no. You don't put me in no hospital.
Mama, the doctor's only trying to do what's best for you.
Nope, ain't going to no hospital. Now, why should I? I'm not even sick. We got the supper dishes to get.
Mama.
You can't get out of bed.
Please, Mama. It's for your own good.
All right. I'll stay in bed. But no hospital. Cost an arm and a leg to stay in those places. Besides, who wants to be in a hospital at Christmas?
Well, if she can rest, be where it's quiet, and have someone take care of her.
No better place in the world than right here in this room.
No. This is your room. I got a nice, comfortable room upstairs.
Mama, now you do what we say or the doctor's going to put you in the hospital. Right, Doctor?
Absolutely right, Reverend.
Now you get some rest.
Night, Mama. Go to sleep here.
Oh, Lord. I'm not afraid of dying. It would be nice being with Curtis again. But if it's not asking too much, could you at least wait till after Christmas? I sure would like to hear Will's first Christmas service in California. If it's not too much trouble. Please. Christmas Eve of 1950. Oh, I had so much to thank the good Lord for that night.
Look who's here.
Grandma! How are you feeling?
Look, Grandma, a Christmas tree.
Oh, you like it?
We made these in school.
I strung the popcorn.
I helped. Oh, now, children, you don't want to upset Grandma. Don't tie her out.
You comfortable, Mom?
Thank you, sir. My. If that isn't the prettiest Christmas tree I ever did see.
Look, Grandma.
A fireplace. Where did that come from?
Joey made it out of the big cardboard box.
Well, it sure had me fooled. I could have sworn that was a real wood-burning fireplace.
Look, Grandma, this is for Santa Claus's reindeer.
Oh, it's beginning to feel more and more like Christmas Eve back in Sweet Clover every minute.
You think you weren't gonna make it?
No, I wasn't worried. I left the door open. Is there any way I can help you?
Yeah, you go inside and keep them busy. And if they hear any noises, you tell them it's church mice.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, George.
That Christmas Eve of 1950. Oh, I had so much to thank the good Lord for that night. Bradley and Rebecca had taken to California like ducks to water. Emmerine had found new friends. And Joy was becoming more and more like Will every day. Will's courage and Sarah's faith kept us all going.
Finally, Christmas. Joey, help me down, Joey. Oh, boy.
Now, if only George Briggs would accept Will's invitation to come to the Christmas services. But we had our family together, love for one another, and we had Christmas.
This fireplace here.
Reindeer must have been hungry last night.
Christmas present for you, Papa. I bought it at the junkyard, but it sounds brand new.
thank the Lord for this wonderful Christmas day. This most wonderful of all days, the birthday of his only begotten Son.
Amen.
Where shall I begin? My heart is so filled with joy, with love, with peace, with goodwill to all men.
Yes, indeed, then.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Do you believe in the Lord?
Yes, I do.
Do you believe in the miracle of Christmas?
Yes.
Put your trust in the Lord, and he won't let you down. Don't you hear him shouting to you? Don't tear my house down. Don't let my house be destroyed. Let my house stand. Don't you hear him?
Yes, sir. Yes, I hear.
Don't you hear God speaking to you? Listen, and you can hear him saying, leave my house be. And you hear his voice, loud, clear.
Loud and clear, Reverend.